with the organization to ensure that the challenges which have been brought to reality by climatic change do not overwhelm our people, because we know that without food there's no security. In fact, I was just talking to the Pope this morning, and saying most of the terrorists gravitate towards terrorism because of hunger. You know, and it's very difficult to convince a man on the street that this is a problem of hunger. So really, we need the presence of the best practices as experienced by the FAO throughout the globe to be passed on to all those deficit areas, so that at the end of the day, the people are able to be self-sustaining in terms of food first, then they can get educated, and they can be able to decide independently. But you know, it's perfect to convince a person on the street that this terrorism you see is linked to hunger. So for me, I'm delighted to be here. The exchange we've had with the Director General and the Deputy fortifies my belief in the organization that together we can achieve something for people worldwide. Because there are elsewhere in areas where people have less impact because of best practices in agriculture and food security. Elsewhere, they're ravaged because of lack of knowledge and expertise and better practices. But with FAO, we are able to disseminate the best practices throughout the globe and ensure that people are able to fend for themselves and meet the challenges as they occur. We've just been talking about things like aquaculture in my country. We are talking about aquaculture and the fact that we can raise enough fish to be able to export. But little did I know that they're already advanced and they're doing that in Mozambique and the other neighboring countries. So without this visit, we wouldn't have known how we can synergize with our neighbors. But as I visit Mozambique very soon, I'll be able to call my colleague, President Felipe, to say, how are you doing it? And I'll find them there. So this visit has been worthwhile.